Well-traveled guy, not from here, from Canada. When you first moved here, did you notice an accent?
Yeah, there were a couple elongated words.
Elongated words.
Like you say, boat.
All right, so that is that's a good example. We do have an accent, a pretty strong one too. So I wanted to understand why us Midwesterners talk the way we do and where it comes from. So I reached out to an old dialect coach. Yes, I had one in TV news. They made me use one because my accent.
Look at me now.
No, yeah, I reached out to her to learn more. Take a look.
It's a bit strange, huh?
We've all heard that strong Minnesota accent portrayed in the TV series Fargo.
Wife made spaghetti for dinner.
You may be thinking, gosh, we don't really sound like that, do we?
Oh, what a day.
And a Minnesota accent isn't as culturally prominent. It's a little more niche. And a lot of what I hear from those actors is like, is this can't be right. You can't say this like that.
You just described the state of Minnesota.
And I'm like, no, we do. That's how we say it, and it's, you know, it's great.
Keely Wolter is an accent and dialect coach based in the Twin Cities who teaches actors, like those vying for roles in the Fargo series, how to sound Minnesotan.
When people think of, like, a Minnesota accent, what they're thinking of is that very, like, white, Eurocentric.
What you doing, hun?
Oh, I'm trying to fix the darn thing.
Euro-immigrant-influenced accent that has like those long O's, those flat A's, that very like Fargo accent that we're thinking of, and that's like that's what's in our heads as the Minnesota accent.
I'm sure you know what you're doing?
And obviously there's lots of other accents here. The accent that you hear in the Twin Cities is different than the accent you hear on the Iron Range.
G53.
Keely tells me our strong O's and flat A's not only have some Scandinavian influence, but also share some similarities to the Irish or Gaelic language.
We do the O as a monophthong.
Okay.
Which means one vowel sound. So a monophthong is like an E is a monophthong because there's only one sound. And we make our O into a monophthong. So we say O.
Oh, hi.
Whereas in a general American accent or other accents in the United States, the O is a diphthong. It has two sounds. So it goes O. Oh. And when I teach it to Minnesotans, who are doing other accents, I'm like, it's the O that you say when you are having an idea and you're like, oh.
Yes.
And you take longer to get there.
And to our neighbors in Wisconsin, or is it Wisconsin? You fall under the Midwestern accent umbrella, but Keely says there are some subtle differences.
Minnesotans tend to tighten and close their mouths more. So we tend to keep our teeth really close together. And we have a little bit of like a
creepy smile when
like we talk. A little creepy smile. No, but it's like if you start to do that, you have that tightness here. You have a tightness in the tongue. And Wisconsin tends to do a lot of the same sounds, but open their mouth a little wider.
Interesting.
Yeah.
It's a lie, okay?
So it was great catching up with Keely.
That's great.
She said one of the biggest signifiers of a Minnesota accent is how we pronounce this. So how do you say this?
Bag? Yeah, bag.
Bag. A lot of times we say bag, and if you go anywhere else in the country, they'll be like, what did you say?
Bag. So it's the elongated A.
A instead of bag.
Ah, bag. Sure. Okay.
Anyway, so we had an interesting conversation, Keely and I, and if you want to learn more about our accent and some tests you can do, I have the entire conversation posted right now at KARE11.com.
Yeah, that was great. I mean, every region has a accent.
And, right.
So it's just interesting to find out why this one's so specific.
Yeah.
Well, Mace, you're here, and you